Hey everyone, Flat Cap Whiskey here. Well, you might be saying, where the heck have you been? Well, it's been a doozy. It's been like 8 months since my last video. I did one YouTube short thing in June. Well, I got COVID. And we'll take that back. My girlfriend got COVID. And then my father got COVID. And then I got COVID. And which destroyed me. What else? I moved in with my girlfriend. So a lot's been going on and I haven't really been doing much. I've been tasting whiskeys though. I got a whole bunch of stuff that I got. But anyway, I was watching John Andre, the famous John Andre, and he was doing a video on top five whiskeys in a particular categories. And those categories were Daily Sipper, Impress Your Guests, a Mixer, something Great, and a Special Occasion Whiskey. Which I watched a couple weeks ago he did it. And I watched it and I've been wanting to do it or do a response to that. So I'm bored today. I haven't had much to do. I finished some chores, made a little coat rack thing, but I want to give you my list of top five whiskeys. Well, five whiskeys in each category, I should say. All right, so the first one is Daily Sipper. And that one was a little difficult for me to choose because the whiskeys that I drink are like three. There's always an island in there. There might be a blended malt, dog barking. So there's three. Well, there's maybe like two runner up for it, because it's a little difficult for me to choose. So I was trying to think of how many bottles I've gone through a particular whiskey or something that I just sit down and just drink. So let's see. The first one will be, of course, Isla Mist. It is a very cheap blended scotch that it's like, what, $20? I've gone through, I think, two bottles of these. And this is the second bottle, so I got to go get a third bottle. If you want to just sip it, go right ahead. You can mix it with something if you really wanted to. Yeah. But you can't go wrong with it. But there's better ones. The other one would be my first scotch that I ever had. Well, no, let me take that back. The second scotch that I've ever had would be Monkey Shoulder. This is probably my fourth bottle of Monkey Shoulder. And I started drinking scotch, let's see, beginning of the pandemic, so 2020. But I've gone through four bottles of this stuff. I love it. Every time I sit down with it, I'm playing a video game. I'm always finding something new every time I drink it. I think it might be one of my favorites. My top 10, I think. But Monkey Shoulder is not the pick I'm choosing. The one I am choosing, it could be either or. But I chose the Cask Strength Laphroaig 10. Now, Laphroaig 10, the normal one, was my first scotch that I've had, and it made me fall in love with scotch. And I've had multiple bottles of the normal 10, but I wanted to choose the cask strength because I think it's a superior to the normal 10, and you can find it pretty practically anywhere, I think. I still see it anyway, and it's like, what, $80? So Laphroaig 10 is my Daily Sipper, and it can be the cask strength or the normal one. But I'm going with the cask strength. We'll put it right here. I don't know if you can see it. Put it next behind the Call of Cthulhu, if you can see it. All right. So the Impress Your Guests category, I struggled with that one. So, because I got some expensive whiskeys or scotches, and will they impress people? Maybe. could do maybe the, like a Johnny Walker blue, because ooh, it's a blue bottle, and it's like over $200. And I was thinking some other ones that I have down here that would be farther down in this in these categories, but what I went with is the old Hazelburn. Hazelburn 10. Let me see if I can get this bottle flipped around. I bought this bottle in, I want to say, also the beginning of the pandemic. Or no. Was it? Yeah. I think it was like 2020-ish. And I found it for, I think, $70 or $80, maybe. It's still the same bottle. I haven't really had much of it. It's probably like right about there. If you're a Scotch drinker and you're coming, if you're a guest or what have you, I just brought some down to my brother down in Florida when I went down there in October. And I just Hazelburn's great. Every time you take a sip of it, it's just it still tastes the same every time I drink it. And there's some things you can find. Like I always find the raisin taste in there, which I love. But this is the 10-year-old. I can't remember which bottling this is. But the next one I know the year. And that's Hazelburn. Alright. For impress your guests. Oh look, we got a dog. She's wondering what I'm doing. Alright. The next category, mixer. Now I've done a couple. I don't really drink mixed drinks, so I was trying a couple of things like a year or two ago. One was some mixed drinks with Laphroaig and Ardbeg. I think Churchill Highball. I think he used the Islay Scotch. So I tried it with that, adding some seltzer water to it, and it wasn't bad. But the one I usually typically go for a mixer is going to be a bourbon. So I chose one of my favorites, Buffalo Trace. I'm not a huge bourbon fan. I got maybe 10 bottles of bourbon. But this is like my third bottle of Buffalo Trace. I typically use it for like hot toddies or an old fashioned. But Buffalo Trace. And it's always like difficult to find here sometimes. So Buffalo Trace. Now, the Something Great category. Again, I had trouble with that one because I think Something Great, Impress Your Friends or Your Guests, and Special Occasion, they kind of can fall in the same categories for all these. All the ones I'm choosing, at least. So, what I chose is a 2019 bottling, which I bought with that Hazelburn, same time frame. And that is the old Springbank 10. It's just perfect in every way. If you can find it, at least, you know. But you just can't go wrong with these Campbelltown whiskey. That's why I think it was really tough to choose this one for Impress Your Guests or the Hazelburn. So you can kind of interchange those two. It is the 10-year-old. I did take this down with my brother as well. And I don't like it as much. Because I just don't want it to go away. But yeah, Springbank 10. Now, Special Occasion. Hey, Nadia. Special Occasion was probably the hardest one to choose for me. Because I have a Blanton's over there that I got recently, which I don't get the hype. It's okay. I only paid like $60 for it, because my local place, you had to buy like two other things with it to get it at a cheaper price. But anyway, I don't know which I'm going to choose. But I would say the runner-up will be the Octomore 11.1. I've only had one dram of this, and I got this 2 years ago. Because this was probably the most expensive scotch that I have bought. And I don't think I can ever go back over that price range. But I've had this at a park. I cracked it open, had it once, and that peat just hits you in the face. It's almost comparable. I think it's almost comparable to like the Kilcairn heavily peated, or like a Port Charlotte. Well, I guess Port Charlotte is the same distillery, but it's really good. But it's not gonna be the whiskey. Special occasion will be this Ardbeg 19-year-old. I'm a little disappointed it's only 46.2%, which is a tad bit higher. But I can't, you know, really complain, because this batch was made during the pandemic, which is actually, I think they have it on here. Where is it? They have it listed somewhere. Oh, bottled. So it's in a lockdown. But it's 46.2. It's matured in American oak and also a little sherry casks. It's non-chilled filtered. I've only had a little bit from it. I gave my coworker who had a baby, I gave him probably like a couple, like 4 ounces of it, so that most of it went towards that. But Ardbeg 10, or Ardbeg 19, I try not to touch it that often. But yeah, I want to do something quick, easy. My co-host, my father, might be, he'd probably be like, why aren't you, where was I during this whole thing? I just want to do something quick. Maybe he can choose his 5 for his category. But, yeah, those were all pretty difficult. I probably could have chose I finished the Kleinleash 14, which I really didn't like. And every time that bottle got lower and lower, I fell more in love with it. I don't know, it's just, I hear people, there's some weird bottling issues with it. But, yeah. I need to make sure this is still recording, because I don't know. It is. I can't really tell with this camera. So anyway, yeah, I finished that bottle. I finished what else did I finish? Some other bottle I finished, I can't remember. Oh, I guess the Island Mist. What else? Been loving that lore. Lore's great. Yeah. That's all I got really to talk about. Been drinking the heavily peated every once in a while. And this IKEA shelf was a pain in the ass. So anyway, that's it. Flapcat Whiskey out.